My father was Abyss Megalo, my mother was Nightmare Mermaid, and after he put his Megalo in her Link Zone, 9 Interruptions was born. 9 Interruption, Atlantean, Orcust!
Bro, I was about to trim my beard today, but then I looked at the time.
Yo, Trim, what's the time?
9 Interruption, Aquaman time.
9 Interruptions.
Boy, I outdid myself today. 9! So if you want to see 9 Interruptions by Atlantean Orcas, hit that thumbs up button! And then after you do that, smash the subscribe button, and then alright button, click it. I know a lot of you guys watch my stuff, but don't even subscribe, man. So for those of you watching, aren't subscribed, I don't care if you're lazy, go create an account, support your boy, hit that subscribe button. 9 Interruptions, enjoy the video! And before we start the video, I got new merch for you guys! I'm not selling a Trip Gaming Electromite cape. That's right, it's a cape, or a playmat, whatever you want to call it. So buy yours in the description below! It's got zones now, double mat, single mat, whatever it may be, no zones, zones! Cheap, affordable, expensive, whatever you want, obviously not expensive. Go check it out in the links below and in the comments below. And without further ado, enjoy this incredible, remarkable video. This is our hand, I'm gonna show you guys how to do the combo here. Doing it on a solo, we'll just show you guys how to do a combo, right? I will do this matches later and do lots of duels with it to show you, but this video is gonna show you the combo quickly, and then as soon as we do the combo as fast as we can, we're gonna show you guys the deck profile near the end. Again, friendly reminder, if you guys like my content, subscribe below, more coming almost every day. Now, let's get started. So, to do this combo, you need 1 of 8 cards. 1 of these 8 are either, 1 of 10 or something. So you need Nepta Abyss Prince, Deep Seed, you have 3 of them. So 3, you have 3 Dragoons, 6. Opening Dragoons results in the exact same combo. The exact same combo. Because opening Dragoons, you just pitch it with the Mermaid and then it gets you the Prince and then you do the whole combo. So 3 Dragoons, because Dragoons is water. So Mermaid pitching it triggers it. You just play a minimal Atlantean Engines. You play triple Prince, triple Dragoons, 1 D.Va, that's 7, plus 1 for 1. So you have 8 cards. 8. Plus you play 4 cards like Upstart, so Upstart and Triple Allure. So you play a 36 card deck, plus you play a shit ton of dangers, which means you're drawing into these 8 every single turn. You're always gonna see them. Now, we're gonna continue with the play here. The rest of the cards are dangers and Orcas cards, and it's extenders, and it's absolutely amazing. So what Dragoons does, so Prince sends Dragoons as Dragoons, right? But now Dragoons doesn't add another Dragoons or a Mulan Glacier, not just yet. It adds this card. I did a video on it before when Sorceress was a card, Summon Sorceress, Lapis Dragon. For those who don't know what Lapis Dragon does, whenever it gets added from your deck or grave to hand, you just can special summon it. It's amazing in that regard that it does that. Now, here we're gonna have lots and lots of options right here. So you're gonna see right here, there's lots of options you can do. So with Mothman, we decide to send out Tsukinoko. We send out Tsukinoko because we wanna make Omega first, so that's how we're gonna get interruption number 1. We want to hand loop them maybe 3 or 4 cards out of their hand. This situation, you can also go into Boreal Savage if you want. You would just put, obviously, you'd have to wait a little bit. You would have to go into the Nightmare cards first and then do it. What I also could have done was just normal Prince. Well, the smarter thing to do is normal Prince and you activate this effect later. You don't have to activate it right away in case you hit one of your waters. So in the future, do that for sure. In the future, normal summon Prince and activate this effect later. You gotta activate it right away. Anyways, we're gonna keep going here. So Omega is going to be 1 year interruptions. The idea here, we want Omega, Mulan Glacier, and Evil Swarm, whatever, the Ouroboros, to get rid of 4 cards from the hands. We're going to handle it for 4 and put up 5 interruptions. And you can literally do it just by 1 Prince and then random dangers. Like, it's so easy. So, I'm going to show you guys a comment now. We're going to keep going. Here's where you pitch Dragoons. Dragoons pitch get Mulan Glacier. So at this point, you have 4 waters engraved, but Mermaid's going to be the 5th. So you're going to go into Galatea, that way Mulan Glacier doesn't get discarded. You want to put Mulan Glacier right away as soon as you can, so Mulan doesn't get discarded. That is 3 cards gone, ripped from their hand. Now it doesn't matter what you discard here, just go dangerous. Summon as many monsters you can on board as possible, and you go into your whole Orcas play now. Eventually you're gonna go into Ouroboros as well, because you're gonna get Brigandine from Rusty. So we're gonna do that. Now we summon Brigandine, banish Cloak, get Brigandine or whatever, and yeah, and then Brigandine, those two dangers. Get Ouroboros. Ouroboros does has 3 effects. The main one, send 1 random card from your opponent's hand to the grave by detaching one. This has 2 other effects you could use on other turns, a targeted card your opponent controls to turn into the hand, etc. But you're just using it really, unless you're going second, playing it just to pitch a card from your hand And now just like that, four cards. You already ripped four cards from the hand. Now you're just gonna Orca's Combo, but plus an extra thing. So you're gonna see right now. So Orca's Combo plus something else. So you're gonna get Babel here. You can get Climax if you want. This same combo could have ended on three cards ripped plus two Omni Negates, plus two or three Interruptions. So, but we opted for more cards ripped because it's more fun. Now, instead of going into Galatea with these three, we're gonna go into Langersu. If you didn't have access to one of the dangers originally, you could always lick away the Moon Glacia, which is okay, but I like keeping it on field. And now we're gonna get another Fog Blade with the boots. And just like that, if you look at this, I'm gonna show you now how many interruptions we have. Just from a very average turn, very average hand, you open one of these eight water ones, you open one of the eight water ones, you win. And the rest of the deck's dangers and draw cards. So you have one interruption in Rusty Dingirsu, that's two. That's two right there, because they're gonna equal two interruptions, one each. One in Langirsu, that's three, because you activate it, obviously with Babel, so three. Two Fog Blades, five, and then four cards ripped from their hand. So they're playing with two cards versus five interruptions. Good luck, have fun! Good luck, have fun to that, bro. Because you're playing with two cards, because you're ripping four cards from their hand with Ouroboros, Omega, and two from Moon Glacia. So you're playing with two cards, and you have five interruptions. Also, what you could have done, as I said, I do play Boreal Savage in here. Plus, for going second, you have so many cards in the next turn. I'm going to show you guys the deck profile in a bit. So many cards for going second. It's unbelievable. The rest of the decks for going second. The rest of the extra deck. So you can go Boreal Savage if you want instead of the Omega, just by doing that a little later in the combo. And then you would end up with one less of an interruption and eight interruptions. But they'd have, you'd play with three cards. You'd have two Omni Negates in Savage and Climax. And instead of this, you get that. And you'll have more other hand traps. But this is more interruptions like this. So like nine interruptions. Not every hand can do nine, because what if you don't draw level four dangers? So most hands are eight. Whoop-de-doo, you have eight interruptions to their five card, you have eight interruptions and they have six cards in total. So four of them are getting banished, or three of them, and you're gonna have five interruptions to their three cards. So like, the Orca's Combo itself will always happen. Also, what I love about this is Lancia. So everyone's signing Lancia, whatever it may be, to against this deck. So if someone signs Lancia, right? If someone signs Lancia against Orca's, which Orca's is weakness, everyone's signing Lancia. Now instead of that, so that's cool, you can't go Omega, that's fine. Omega turns into Boreal Savage Dragon, right? So they Lancia, they're gonna Lancia the second they see the mermaid, right? They Lancia, they're gonna, or you keep Omega doing the standby phase with the same thing, you keep Omega, doesn't matter. They're still gonna lose four cards, and you're still gonna Rusty though. So even through Lancia, they're still losing four cards, so plus they Lancia, so they're gonna be left with one card versus the Orca's Combo. So, sorry, they're not, you can't Orca's Combo, you can Rusty though. You also play one underclock, because if they Lancia, you just go underclock, and with the danger, you go with the waters, and then you just go Rusty. So you end up with some combination of double Fog Blade and four cards looped, or like three cards looped and two Fog Blade, and they Lancia. So they'll be left with two cards, and you got two Fogs. You know what I mean? Or if they Lancia you. Or if they Lancia, you just get rid of the other four, so you're left with one card. Like, sure. And you Orca's their ass next turn. So that's the combo for you guys. I'll do way more videos in the future with it. I love this deck. It's so fun to play. I call it Triff Males, and here is the deck profile. Triff Males is the name of it, because Triff's a male. Ha, dad joke. Okay, Deep Sea Diva, three Prince, three Dragoons. These seven, you need the combo, one for one. These eight is how you do the combo. Draw one of these eight and you do it. If you don't hard draw them, it doesn't matter, because you have 15 Upstart Goblins, 16 Upstart Goblins, you have 19 cards to draw. You have 19 cards to draw into them. You're gonna easily be able to resolve it. Next, you play one Lapis Dragon, that's all you need, because free summon, and then that's how you get the level 5 tuner on board. And worst case scenario, just it's a one card nightmare combo. We do not play Connector or Dolphin, because they are not a one card Moon Glacia. We want to ensure that Moon Glacia is going to resolve. If you Connector Dolphin, if you need Dragoons in hand. If you Connector Dolphin a Prince, you still can't do the combo. If you Connector Dolphin, I understand you get rid of a card from the hand, but I don't care about hand traps whatsoever. Like, what are you hand trapping that'll stop me? You're like, nothing. You could Ash my Mermaid, I wouldn't care less. If you hand trap anything, you're still getting your ass Moon Glacia. You're still getting Omega, you know what I mean? So, and then if you don't Ash the Mermaid, you're gonna get five interruptions on your ass. So going first is next amazing, going second is even more amazing, because they don't know what's coming, you sign into hand trap to end turn, and look at your extra deck that absolutely obliterated decks going second. Now, I'm gonna continue after this water break. That was great. Now, Diva, three of these, Dragoon, roll up, it's one Moon Glacia, perfect. Now, three Nessie, three Sukunogo, three Jack. I only play three Mont and three Chupacabra because they allow you to put up dice in rank four and tell you to send four cards away with Ouroboros. Next, you play two Nightmare, one Horror, one Skeleton. In theory, you don't need to play two Skeleton because if you draw it, you just summon it itself, or like, it will send it to the grave by night by dangers and then activate its effect. But Mermaid's effect is important to resolve in this combo, so for this deck especially, you need to play two. But I do find if you're just throwing orcas in as an engine, you don't need to play two. The only reason you play two before is just in case you hard drew it and you can't mermaid off. But that's what depends on. You can pen summon it or danger discard it. It doesn't matter. You'll resolve it anyways. One horror, one skeleton, one cloak, one boots, one for one upstart, triple allure. You need drop power, one bobble, one night, a crescendo. One other thing to note is what's that card called? Danger, Ogopogo is a sea serpent. You can add it with Dragoons if you need, but it's just a cute play. You don't ever need to do it. Back when rank up was still a card and you do rank 8 plays with Moon Glacier is cool, but you would never actually search for Ogopogo. You'd much rather search Lancer anyways, and then Moon Glacier. So there would never be a situation where you would rather search Ogopogo as opposed to one of these instead. Or D.Va if you didn't use a normal summon or something like that. Or if you had special pitch Dragoons and then get D.Va to special up Prince. Now, that's amazing. You can take a crescendo for Ogopogo. Another thing you could do is put in one Abyss Megalo. Maybe this is how I can get the 10 interruptions. You put in one Megalo and one Mizukuchi or whatever. Is that card similar to my name? What's the mermaid spell? Abyss Scale Mizuchi. Ha! Trifuchi. Abyss Scale of the Trifuchi, but it's not good enough, so we're gonna get rid of that. Crescendo, honestly, you're going for battle most of the time anyways, but Crescendo is cool to have as a follow-up as well. One Brigadine, two Fogbait. I do believe you're playing two of these, but you must play three of these as well, because if you draw one of the four, you're going to be left with one card minus you're not going to get, and drawing these traps don't matter. If you draw one of these traps, you're still getting the other two. So you draw one of these five, and it doesn't matter, you're still going to end up with all three of the traps, so it doesn't matter. Hand traps, I just like hand traps that end turns. Any hand trap that does not end turns, I'm not interested in. The rest of the hand traps suck ass. No material ends turns. Lancia ends turns. Draw ends turns. The other card hand traps do not end turns. They just slow them down a bit, but they don't do jack shit. Don't put any other hand trap as long as it doesn't end turns. Cherries for some decks, but it's not worth it right now in the meta. Three cycle to Twister for mine and whatever else you want. All the nightmares but Griffin and both Borals. You have so much space in the deck for going second, so I want to max out a good card going second for this deck. Galatea, one Longirsu. Longirsu is just great. Underclock, Rusty, one Dengirsu, one Night, Evil Swim Nightmare, one Ouroboros. You could take them out with Cyber Dragon, Omega. In theory, I prefer getting rid of cards from their hand just in case. And if they hand trap you, they just do your job for you. So it's actually fantastic. This is the video, guys. It's honestly so underrated. Let me know in the comments below if you want me to do future videos of me destroying meta with it. Alliant Orcas is too damn powerful! So if you haven't already, if you enjoyed this video, if you guys made it this far, hit the subscribe button, smash the like button, and we'll see you guys in tomorrow's video. Peace.